Hi, in this video I will talk about gaming functionalities you can find in TCL2 2022 TV sets and how you can use them. There are four major gaming options in our TV sets. So first one is Game Center, so casual games. If you look for just standard entertainment, you can go to this Game Center from your home screen and have games. Then another one is Game Streaming. Stadia just announced that will stop end of this year, but we believe that new functionalities, new game streaming functionalities are on the way and soon will be available. Console gaming over HDMI, and then PC gaming also over HDMI. In case of console gaming, PC gaming, you can also use streaming services, and then you can play this using TV set as the screen. Then game consoles evolve, and then every 7 years there is new game consoles. So as the average lifetime of the game console is 7 years, but you see that even between the 7 years there are refreshes and slight improvements. But almost 9 years ago, generation 8 was focused on 720p and 30 frames. Then right now we have game consoles focused on UHD and 60 frames. If you want to play in 120, you have to decide that you won't have all the details on the screen. And that's why soon we will have new refresh of game consoles. But these game consoles and PCs, and fact that almost 20% of households have game consoles, push TV sets also to deliver gaming functionalities. On the one side, HDMI 2.1 48G for UHD 120 and 144 gaming. Then Game Bar, which helps you to see all the settings and switch between DRR, between also see frame per seconds, decide on AGAG what kind of settings you want to use. Why VRR is important? Because game consoles are rendering frames, and then if the rendering time is longer, that refresh time of the screen, and with I think 120 frames, we talk about, if I calculate well, 8 milliseconds. So then if it takes longer, so then you start to see tearing or stutter. So tearing when you see only half of new frame, stutter if almost frame is done but timing is wrong. So that's why VRR is helping that TV set is refreshing the screen according to ability of the game console. You can have the best picture settings. Then what is the input lag? You see here that in standard movie mode we talk about sometimes even 300 milliseconds, but for game console we need 5 milliseconds for you to don't feel that there is any delay when you play your best game. Then you see that all our products are fully compatible with either Xbox or PlayStation. We fulfill all the requirements. However, if you want to have the best experience, you have to properly calibrate the picture to see all the details. It's important to do it because then TV set is not mapping and adapting to HDR, but it is console which is sending properly what TV set can display. For Xbox, for PlayStation, it looks different, but you see results here.